Hello, and welcome to the 191 Tale of the Two Yuan start date. This is a scenario that focuses largely on the conflict between Yuan Shu and Yuan Shao, showing how Yuan Shao effectively came to be in possession of the north in its entirety, while Yuan Shao, in the strongest position of the central plains outside of Dongchua, manages to fail at everything and ends up in a rump state before declaring himself emperor and getting himself slaughtered. Oh, anyway, the reason we are starting is Dongchua. Someone in the comments of one of my previous videos mentioned that playing as Lu Bu, following from the event chains, results in Dongchua being taken off camera, shall we say, is quite difficult. However, I have played around with this a tiny bit, and I can see there are two alternative options for this. And they are, depending on what cities you have when that event chain fires, if you are playing as Dongchua and you only have these three cities and you haven't taken back Luoyang, you inherit the faction as Lu Bu in Chang'an, and you take with you what appears to be most of the imperial court. It's a very powerful start. I will not be doing that, as we're going for a little bit more of a challenge, and I am going to take Luoyang within the first 3 months of the campaign. The event chain starts in January 192 and ends in February 192, at which point we become Lu Bu. So what I am going to do, I am going to spend the first few turns, well, I've got first nine turns of the campaign searching for every item that we can find in Chang'an. I'm going to surround and take over Luoyang, make sure it is fully supplied. I want to point out that in this start date, we do start with quite a high title, or high rank, so we can appoint some of our many capable officers to some very potent titles, and we do carry those over as Lu Bu. So it's not a terrible start. However, we aren't going to acquire most of the officers that we start with here. We are going to end up with most of Lu Bu's followers that you see in Puyang and then later on Jiapi. So I'm going to cut back in 3 months, in January 192 or perhaps February 192, once I'm in Luoyang and I am playing as Lu Bu. In regards to events, I am not going to activate the Fall of Sun Jian event, as it's broken in this scenario. And what I mean by broken is that it causes Sun Ce to inherit the faction. Most of Sun Ce's officers go to join Yuan Shu, and Sun Ce just remains behind in a little rump state in Changsha. It just doesn't really make any sense. It should have Sun Ce join Yuan Shu in its entirety, and then perhaps pop up later on in, say, Lujiang or another empty city, but it doesn't work like that, so I won't be activating that event. However, I will activate the events that give Cao Cao his cities in the central plains, the events that give Yuan Shao and Gongsun Zan their cities, and the events that relocate Liu Bei to Xiaopi. Anything that creates a more interesting dynamic in the central plains, I will be doing. Anything else, I will ignore. It's January 192, so the events begin. The first one is the one of two events that starts the execution of Dongchua. And then we have the Qing Province Yellow Turban event, which gives Puyang over to Cao Cao. It's the event that really gave him his head start in the central plains. And I think lastly, there is the event that... Oh, there's two events now. There's the event that gives Gongsun Zan Ji in the north, and the event that gives, it doesn't actually give anything for now, it just makes Cao Cao hostile to good old, I've forgotten your name, Tao Qian, which in a few turns will let Liu Bei avoid annexation by Yuan Shao, and he'll relocate to Xiaopei. This event here, the Battle of Guangting, relocates Yuan Shu out of Wan, all the way over to, somewhere in the southeast, Lujiang. This will actually give Yuan Shu, who is allied with Sun Jian, what might be free reign over the southeast as it happens. So this will and spice things up a little bit. Liu Biao is now sandwiched between two hostile factions, depending on if their alliance lasts. And Kong Cho down in Runan is, well, he's surviving, and that's really sometimes all you can do. Okay, here we are. This is where things start to kick off. There's two events here. You want to pick the event that says Conclusion Lu Bu. And that will change our faction over to Lu Bu. We're not going to... see, we've only got 15 officers, so most of the other officers have ended up in Chang'an. I'll review who we have in a moment. Just mainly to make sure Liu Bei gets to safety in Xiaopei. So, let's have a look at our faction. Who do we have? We have Lu Bu, Zhang Liao, Gao Xun. Notably, Lu Ji and Zhu Jun are free in the city. And then we have a lot of the regular Lu Bu underlings. We do have Dio Chan, Yan Shi and Du Shi. Yan Shi is Lu Bu's wife, and Dio Chan is the famous concubine. What sets Dio Chan apart is that she has a tactic that has AoE disorder and restrained. She has instrumentalist for nearby officers that raises the morale each turn, and gorgeous, which lowers the stats of enemy units. So she is a fantastic candidate for just having in any army in goose formation with 1,000 troops. She's particularly good here as she has synergy with Lu Bu. But not only that, we can marry her off in 1 year's time to Zhang Liao, and then she'll be a confidant for both Zhang Liao and Lu Bu while weakening enemy units while having chances to carry out chain tactics. She's a fantastic little addition to our army. Other than that, the big three, Lu Bu himself, makes him good. He has freedom of movement. He's not blocked by any land-based terrain, so he's incredibly quick. He has a tactic that will sometimes outright kill units, and he has a fantastic doctrine policy. Fish, arrow, goose. A goose. He has all the formations you'll want. 9 times out of 10 he'll be in fish, occasionally goose where the situation calls for it. But he is the focal point of the army. You have Lu Bu on the field and you want him to be on the field up until his tactic activates, and then you win a battle against whoever you're fighting. Zhang Liao and Gao Xun are quite similar, but Zhang Liao is better. Zhang Liao has a unique tactic that does a fair amount of damage and lowers the assault of enemy, as you can see. He's another fish formation officer that can make use of arrow, and occasionally snake, though I don't really make use of that much often. Notably, he has heroic, which causes him to get into duels more often. His high strength means he'll often win those duels, and courageous means at 3,000 troops or less, his unit is quite potent. Gao Xun has that trait as well. He does a little bit more of a damage to cities, and he has a unique tactic which does damage to cities that can be activated in fish formation, which as far as I know is unique for him. He can also be quite a strong ram formation officer as well, so he's a sort of siege weapon expert. Our ideal army at the start will be Lu Bu, Zhang Liao and Gao Xun, with Dao Chan and Yan Shi in the back acting as support. Very straightforward. Very fun when it works, very frustrating when you're sat there waiting for Lu Bu's tactic to activate. And in terms of items we've inherited from Dong Chuo's force, we've got of course the 7-star sword, which we'll give straight over to Zhang Liao. We're going to give everyone a bit of a promotion. So Zhang Liao is now well over 100 strength, 101. Very potent unit. We have some politics items. I don't think we have any particularly good politics officers at the moment. Maybe Wang Yan. I'm going to sit on those for now. And a +3 intelligence item, which I'm also going to sit on for now. But speaking of which, Dio Chan is our best candidate, believe it or not, for strategists at the start of the game. But what we want to do with the... I think the incredible... No, that's, I don't want you acting as overseer there. See, he raises public order by 2, but if I put Zhang Liao there, he raises it by 3. Strange choice, but There we are, it is what it is. Wang Yan, of course, is going to be the overseer for the port, so fill that up. Notably, we haven't got the Hu Lao Gate, but I'll talk about that when it becomes relevant. But what is relevant now is trying to hire these spare officers, particularly... Oh, I haven't actually got administration. I was going to say particularly Lu Ji. No, yes, our administration is lacking at the moment, so particularly Lu Ji and Zhu Jun. These are later Han officers that you rarely ever see in action. Not only are they quite good, Lu Ji is a strat candidate for strategist, and Zhu Jun has summoner. And they also have synergy with each other. So our first job is to... Lost my train of thought, I do apologise. Our first job is to try and hire them. And then with our spare turns, our singular one spare turn, we're going to try and search for an officer. Sometimes when you're an uncharismatic ruler with a bad strategist, that's how it goes when trying to hire. 0 for 6. However, I do want those officers. So I am going to spend a fair amount of turns at the start trying to hire the two of them, as we haven't got that many troops. Well, we've got plenty of troops, which you'll certainly need, but we haven't got that many officers. So Dio Chan, if you would be so kind. And Wang Yan, you two. And then of course, just... try and hire any of these spare bandit officers that are in Luoyang as well. I've just managed to hire Zhu Jun, so I will be appointing him as my recruiter, as he can boost that somewhat, even if our recruitment in Luoyang is quite low. And I know it looks like we have a lot of troops, but between the sandwiching of Cao Cao and Li Jue, those troops will... well, they will deplete faster than we would like. So, Lu Ji will hopefully join us soon. Along with these other random officers, and then we can begin recruiting in the city. Okay, I've hired Lu Ji. So, Lu Ji is a candidate for, well, two items. Three items, in fact, I think, arguably. My politics item. But most importantly, my life extension item. Because Lu Ji does not live very long. Neither does Zhu Jun, sadly, but I do only have the one life extension item, so I have to pick and choose who I'm going to keep. And the reason I am making this choice is that for now, Lu Ji is one of our best candidates for strategist. Only slightly better than Diao Chan. Unless I gave him an intelligence item. Yes. No, not the sword, not the sword. He's not going to be a warrior. There we are, 88 intelligence, and his policy for the people will help our recruitment slightly, as well as our domestic development. Our other policies are awful, and we simply don't have the officers to really make use of any particularly good policies, really. We've hired Yang Fen, who is almost irrelevant apart from the fact that he has fish level 3 and unfettered, so he is going to go straight into administration to get fish up to level 10. At this point, I want to talk about the Hu Lao Gate and the pros and cons of taking it. Defending gates is tricky. Assaulting them is awful, but defending them is also tricky. So, the Hu Lao Gate is only going to be attacked from our position from Suan Zhao. Now, in the Hu Lao Gate, the area, which includes this little bit of land to the left and this little bit of land to the right, there are two supporting cores for Lu Bu and one supporting core for Cao Cao. So it is decent to fight Cao Cao against. However, the way your stat changes are affected by supported cores is the stat differences, the increases or the decreases, are changed at the end of the turn. And I apologise for the clunky way of explaining this, but why I want to highlight this is that Suan Chao has 5 supporting cores, and on extreme difficulty, any unit coming from here to here to here is going to be eye-wateringly powerful up until the turn ends, and then their stats will update. So if we have, say, Chang Liao, Lu Bu, Gao Shun stationed here defending the gate, any unit that comes along here gets into battle for the remainder of the turn will be incredibly powerful, and they will do a huge amount of damage to us. And yet, if we stay behind the gate, we will lose a battle of attrition. The gate will take damage from durability, from casual attacks, from fire notably. The AI loves to use fire, as it's a prominent theme in my videos, if you've seen me getting abused by fire attacks. So I do not like to sit in the gate and have archers stationed behind us on extreme difficulty, especially with Cao Cao's officers, Cao Ren and Cao Cao with their high defence. I don't think you win the battle of attrition. So I think if we can fight Cao Cao in this area here, Chen Gao, we have 4 supporting areas and they have 1. And even if they take the Hulao gate, they're still only fighting us here, to here, to here, to here, to here, with 1 supporting area. So I think, what I would like to do, with an officer who is quite capable with politics, let's say Lu Ji, if the game will let me, okay, I have to do it that way. I want to funnel the AI for attacking me outside Chen Gao, where I will have stronger officers, stronger units, and they'll be able to win battles at a higher ratio of troop damage inflicted to troop damage received than I would fighting a traditional battle outside the gate. It's also why I haven't taken the Tong Gate, because the Tong Gate is incredibly well reinforced. So even if Li Jue has done weird things, where have your troops gone, Li Jue? Yeah, you've got the same amount of troops as me. Where the hell are they? 8,000 here. 5,000. You can't be losing to Ma Chao that badly. Well, Li Jue with his scattered troops is somewhat of a threat, and I might actually act on this now. But I don't want to fight at the Tong Gate, I want to take it and then immediately move on to the surrounding areas, which I will probably do shortly, looking at how thinly spread he is. There he is. Here is Yu Huang located in Luoyang. The reason I didn't search for officers at the start of the video is if I hired Zhu Huang, he would have just gone and joined the Imperial Court. So I'm hoping to make use of Zhu Huang in this video, as I'm very rarely on this channel, if ever, used him. I've done it. Zhu Huang has joined the faction. Let's give him a promotion. I think he's fully loyal now. His policy isn't too much use to us, but there is a plus 10 strength sword in Luoyang I can find. Once I have that sword, I can do a little bit of item juggling and make him quite a potent officer. Literally the next turn, I find it. There we are. That item is actually quite easy to find, the Tao Te Ching plus 10 intelligence item in Luoyang. Sometimes you just won't find it. I was at one point convinced it wasn't in the city or that my game was glitched, but it seems to have something like a 1% chance or something absolutely absurd probability of finding him. So we've got the plus 8 strength item. I'm going to upset Zhang Liao a little bit by giving that to Zhu Huang. Oh no, he's not upset. But I can then give the Crescent Halberd over to Zhang Liao for a very slight improvement. So Lu Bu now has a plus 10 strength white item. And at this point, I think I can even begin to do a little bit of trading. Do I want to send Lu Ji? No, because we might need him in battle. Don't want to send. Oh, we just haven't got the political officer. So if I send Lu Ji. Oh, this is dreadful. We're not sending our best. I think they're not ready for this. Yeah. Okay. Give them a treasure. And just hope for the best. Once they come back, they will have a plus 10 leadership item, which is particularly good for Lu Bu. And then I think I will look to deploy for Chang'an. I don't know what Chen Yu is doing there. I don't know what else to add to that. Chen Yu is doing things. Speaking of things, I am going to. Oh, we are very, very low on supplies. I may have to wait for a merchant to spawn. Yeah, 40,000. We've got too many troops and not enough food generation because we are living in the post sacked Luoyang. And these areas, you can see their populations. They haven't got a single area of 10,000 people in it. They are devastated. So this is a very poor city, even if it is a very secure city. Okay, Chang'an is vacant. I haven't seen this before in any of my tests. I don't have an explanation as to why WeChat has decided to empty Chang'an completely. But it speeds up our eventual plan to try and make our way into Shu, I suppose. Which is the sort of. Ooh! Okay, is he coming for us? Did I send the other wife? Yes, I did. Oh dear. Well, that wasn't my best move. What tactics do I have to teach people? Zhujun. Yeah, you can have Riley. So I am just going to have frontliner Zhu Huang. I didn't actually teach you Riley, yes I did. And these two backliners. And hopefully this works. Okay, are they taking the bait? Yet to be seen, but they may be doing so. Need to move some officers around to get those supplies in place. Still no merchant, and we are very low on food. But Zhu Huang is. See, he's better than what we're up against. And. They're not going to get any weaker, but they're still quite strong. If he goes around there, it's not really going to make any difference. Is he just going to march forward? I am curious. Is he going on an all-out assault for us? We'll have to see. Zhu Huang, it's all up to you. Oh, look at that. We've just shared a volley. Well, the thing with Zhu Huang is he has a unique tactic that causes AoE damage a fair amount and increases his defense. So he is a lot stronger once that tactic activates. Up until then, he's somewhat limited. There we are, and Yu Huang, of course, has heroic, which I've not mentioned, but it allows Yu Huang to do things like that. It'd be nice if we captured Han Hao. No, oh well. It does make him weaker, hurting his morale like that. And in comes Cao Cao. No. Oh, another volley. This is actually quite scary. Very scary, but am I going to want to pull this assault back? Now am I on for food? This is like a traditional Lu Bu blunder where he attacks a city that he shouldn't be attacking, but he does so because he's recklessly aggressive. Nope, didn't need to do that. Okay, we'll play it by ear in that regard, Yu Huang. In fact, no, what we'll do, we'll retreat back to the city. Okay. No, retreat! What kind of retreat involves going forward? Well, I hope Zhu Huang gets off his unique tactic now, because that was atrocious. He just moved forward. For what reason? So now they're now slightly stronger. But Cao Cao is stretching himself thin. Maybe Liu Bei will be our saviour. Okay, before I attack the city, I can see these units are coming along and... Okay, this is going to be dangerous place for us to fight. So, everyone's going to have to, I think, move back a little bit. And just try and play this a bit slow. Volunteers! Ah, the timing couldn't be better. Couldn't be perfect, couldn't be more perfect. Okay, maybe if Zhu Huang gets back into the city, we'll be okay. Okay, I don't like this at all. I do not like this at all. But... this might be okay. So they only have two supporting areas here versus the three in the city. So if I can maybe pull back a turn. If we get attacked from behind, then it's all over. So we're just going to assume the AI is not strong enough to do that. Okay, so the plan here, I'm going to send Zhu Huang out as bait. 10,000 troops, I think. Just Zhu Huang by himself. While I am doing that, I have two... Don't be reckless. Ah, okay, never mind that. They're reckless. So my snake formation officers, are you also reckless? No. You have every other bad trait in the game, but you aren't reckless. So... I'm going to try and cut off Cao Cao. Okay. How are we looking? Is he just going for the camp? This gives us more time. Zhu Huang, he is taking a very, very, very bad trade here. Oh, okay, there's my opportunity. I think I see it. Zhu Huang just needs to survive, or even better, potentially get into a duel or two. How are they? Still in the wrong area. Can we build a camp behind us? Yes, we can. Oh, that's brilliant. I'm scared of sending Lubu forward in case he gets into aggro range. We're okay for now. I think we're okay here. Okay, come on, Zhu Huang, do your thing, get a duel. Zhahudun. Are you going to win this? 99 strength, heroic 91. Yes, that was an essential win. Capture him. No. Okay. And I would very much like your tactic to activate, preferably against Cao Cao. Cut them off. Come on. Okay, now, how are we looking here? Okay, Lubu's going to get into the fray. Inferno! What else would you do other than set me on fire? Okay, let's not get too mad about that. It's just a game. It's not programmed to always set me alight. Did that even build? Yes, it did. Good. That's just the fire damage. So I want Lubu to get off one of his famous tactics here to hopefully kill all three of them. And the surround paid off. Okay, so where are my snake units here? Nope. And my arrow units? My strongest ones. Oh, you are only snake. Okay, well, we'll have to do. And you? Cut him off. I hope Lubu doesn't waste his tactic on just this guy by himself. Okay, Gaoxun's not taking too much damage apart from the fire. Hechue is melting. Lubu's gonna find his next target. And Sanji is being caught. Okay, not a bad trade. There we go. He's dead. Don't know how much damage that did, but it was enough. And we can even surround Zhang She here. All in all, not too bad. Speaking of not too bad, so you've been captured, and Zhu Huang, you can have the honour of finishing him off. That might be Cao Ren coming in for more, but I am not particularly worried about that. So we're going to cut off Zhang She here. He's going to do minuscule damage to us. Or as it turns out, none at all, as we capture him. And Luo Yang. Okay, so the alliance between Cao Cao and Yuan Shao has ended. So that, in theory, gives us some free time. Can I build an arrow tower there? Okay, that's interesting. That might actually help us. Might. Because these won't be particularly defensive units, so... I mean, can I even build a fire trap there? No, maximum number of buildings for whatever reason. That's annoying. What I'm going to do here, I am going to have everyone retreat back into the city, well, not the city, the gate, and I think I'm going to redeploy with a siege weapon to try and do some serious damage to Chang'an. No, you're not having your officer back. You want to make him ours. Come on, Zhu Huang. No, you're actually going to get into range, aren't you? Okay, they won't join us, but their loyalty is dropping. They might join us eventually. Come on, Zhuhuang, build this arrow tower. Annoying. Well, we got the tower up. And this is going to cause a little bit of damage. And a duel with Sal Ren, that is exactly what I needed. Get his morale down, weaken him. Maybe even capture him if I'm lucky. Am I lucky? No, never lucky. And now he's defensive. Okay, so Zhuhuang, it is your time to make a timely retreat from this battle. While Sal Ren takes... Yeah, if you were in fish formation, it would be a little different. Unless Zhu Zhen himself can get into position to cut off Sao Ren. Okay, we'll try that. I'm teaching my One Disorder Tome to Zhang Liao, so he might be able to use it when we attack the city of Chang'an. The reason I am not appointing volley is, even though direct damage to the city is nice, I want the opportunity to be able to one-shot an enemy unit if they deploy. It's not guaranteed, I wouldn't even say it was likely, but it's convenient when it does happen. It's an RNG battle winner, for a lack of a better way of describing it. And I think we might be okay here. I don't want to speak too soon. Are there any more reinforcements on the way? No. Cao Cao is spread so thin, but he's determined to concentrate on me. Okay, Zhuhuang is going to... Oh, he's not going to retreat by the looks of it. And we're not actually going to get Sao Ren cut off. But... I can't see why Cheng Yu won't get caught up in that, potentially. I should have changed my administration to get slightly stronger crane formation. Not something you hear me say very often on this channel. Okay, in fact, maybe I'll move him there. And we'll just... No, we'll stick to the original plan. Okay, he's actually going after Zhuhuang. That's really unexpected. These two are just trading blows. Provoke. I don't like the trade that's taking place there. Yujin's going to get in the way, but with my mobility advantage and Sao Ren now cut off, I can build another arrow tower here. That's interesting. Or better yet, just cut him off completely. I wasn't paying attention. What is going on over here? This is the age-old story of Lu Fu getting involved in battles he has no business being involved in. Move everyone over carefully. Let's hope we're not exposing our front lines here, and let's pray. Okay, so we have over here Sao Ren about to die from lack of morale. And over in Chang'an, Lu Bu's on fire and he's taking 1,000 damage already. Okay, Dio Chan's going to be doing some damage here. Sounds like Sao Ren's just died in the background. Zhang Liao's come to help. Our terrible twins are dead. Lu Bu's taking some damage from the city. Okay, are you going... Oh, Chariot, that's annoying. Lu Bu's at half strength, but... I'm not massively worried about that. And Cheng Yu is completely cut off, and Yue Jin looks like he's attacking the city. So I'll leave Yue and Zhu Jun to finish off Cheng. Maybe I won't. Maybe, no, in fact, I'll have Zhu Jun cut off Yue Jin, because he's the better defense. And Zhu Huang can finish off Cheng Yu. I've taken 3,000 casualties so far. Not a very good ratio by any means. But at least it's a battle one. Okay, so move up out of. That's annoying. I'm going to have to move you into the fire. I'm going to have to move you into the fire. Move you out of the fire. And this might be our chance to take Chang'an. So Zhu Huang here. Finish off Cheng Yu, capture him if you would. Oh, he's never going to betray us, betray Cao Cao anyway. And that is Yue Jin. Oh, never bad trade. And has he got reinforcements on the way? No! Okay. So we can at least destroy Yue Jin and retreat back into the city. Whew, that was tough. Speaking of tough, are you in range of? No, you're not buffing Zhang Liao up, so he's at somewhat weaker stats than he should be. Wubu's at full strength and the city's disordered. Oh, that is brilliant. This should be Chang'an. This should be Chang'an. Okay, Zhang Liao's got an opponent. Doesn't really matter if he has, because he will. Huh, he'll act as a. Okay, now it's scary. Now it's very scary. But not so scary if Chang'an falls, and less scary if Zhang Liao captures Zhang Ji. We have his son, or his nephew, I think, yeah, nephew, in our prison cells. Be nice if we could get him as well to match. Very good result, Zhang Liao. Okay, let's upset the regional warlords. Okay. That's not. Nope, don't set fire to that space. No, Wu Boon will need to get in. We'll need to get in there. Yao Chan will need to move there, and we'll just wipe these out. Oh, in fact, Zhang Liao, you can join in as. No. Gao Xun, you can join in as well. This is where Courageous comes into play, makes him slightly stronger. And Luo Yang looks to be safe for now. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to destroy him and retreat as soon as is possible. Okay. Yeah, that's okay. We are. There's that tactic. Didn't capture him, complete waste. Okay, Yue Jin looks to have survived for long enough to cause us some inconvenience. Okay, back into the city. Run, 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 everyone. Back into the city. No, just going to sit there, I suppose, and why would you not? Why, of course, would you not? Okay, if you could ever so kindly, which, how have they caught up? You're a cavalry formation officer. Oh, 94 loyalty. I would really like to have Cheng Yu, but I don't think it's likely to happen. But what we can do now, Chang'an is safe. we can... first of all, how much gold have we got? Not enough. Okay. So we can move Zhang Liao Bu Gao Shun Yan Shi back over. Dio Chan is going to try and hire. No. It's not exactly who I'd like. No, I can't use you, Zhu Huang. You might be needed for the defense. And next turn, we'll deploy using our main army to defend Luoyang, which should be easy enough to do. Scary. Okay, we've got Zhang Ji, another political officer who will be capable. Cao Cao and Zha Hudun, a terrible duo to have to try and fight against when together, especially. What can we do here? Where should we fight Lu Bu? Where should we fight? Well, that goes without saying, first of all. One more turn and my officers are back from the trade delegation, so that helps a little bit. And have I got anyone else I can hire? Oh, too far away. But Zhang Shi should be joining us. What I might do is have Chang Liao and Gao Shun. 3,000 troops. Move around the outskirts. Okay. Nope. Nope. That's a surprise. Okay, here you go. I need these officers back. And Lu Bu now has a plus 10 bonus to his leadership, so he's more scary than ever. These two can build a arrow tower, as we've seen before. It was somewhat useful, even as a temporary measure. And then we just move everyone else who has any domestic capability back over. Not you, and not you, obviously. Over. And have we got any hiring options available? Wei Xie. Maybe. If Cheng Yu's loyalty were to drop just a little bit, I'd be tempted to use him. Okay, it looks like they're taking the bait. They're going for Zhang Liao. I think that's okay. And a joint tactic to destroy Zha Hudun and capture him. And Cheng Yu escaped from the city. Well, I will ransom Zha Hudun if Cao Cao wants him back, which I'm sure he will want. Come on, Cao Cao. Give me the money for your trusted advisor. And how do we go about this now? Maybe there? Yeah, Han Hao can't do too much to these two. And then maybe next turn we send out Wu Bu as the shock troop. Are they retreating? Or are they trying to attack Zhang Liao? Okay, Zhang Shi, fantastic, welcome to the squad. He is coming for us. That's interesting. Cao Cao isn't. And Lu Bu. Daring Lu Bu. Finish them off. Thankfully, volunteers have arrived. We could not need them more. They could not come at in a more opportune time. That helps us a great deal. I mean, if we look here, I simply do not have the officers available or the troops. I am down to 36,000 troops. And I am winning these battles, but I am taking hefty amounts of casualties each time I win a single battle. Okay. We are going to have a battle here by the looks of it. Is that Ganning in cavalry formation coming for us? Of course it is. Why would it not be? No, they're going to march into the gate. Well, this isn't going to work well for Cao Cao. Be nice to capture him. I think I'd potentially even kill him in this campaign if I do get my hands a hold of him. It's a big if. How are we looking on food? I see. Well, it's nice to have a nice big stockpile of gold. Not Yanxi, she's gonna potentially be leaving the field. Shame I just had to go spend it all. Yanxi, if you wouldn't mind, go cheer on our army. Strength of Wei, which isn't gonna be enough to save Cao Cao from Lu Bu. However, he does have a horse, so Cao Cao will be able to escape. Ah, look at that. We live to see another day. So I'll just have Lu Bu march in there. I think we'll call this an episode. This is the end of part one. Lu Bu has survived. We are toe-to-toe with Li Jue, two cities for two cities. Li Jue is a larger selection of officers, but I think we have a superior selection of officers. And Ma Teng is the wild card. Will he act as a distraction against Li Jue? Quite possibly. I'm not thinking Chang Lu will deploy against us. Chang Lu may even be an ally against the forces of Cao Cao. So we are stable, for lack of a better phrase. And I think, can we even at this point start recruiting? Yes, we can. We can now just about recruit from two cities. So I'm going to end this here. I think the next episode we will look to lock down Liang while continuing to fight off Cao Cao's increasingly scary offences. Yuan Shao isn't providing any relief. Why is Hung Fu Song working for Yuan Shao? Well, anyway, Gong Sun San, he's doing quite well for now, but what happens? He often ends up burning through his initial troops and then he can't keep up with Yuan Shao, really. It depends on if he can break Nanpi. Looking at how things stand now, the answer is, to that question, can he break Nanpi? Probably going to be no. His officers aren't quite the same quality, and he's probably, yeah, he's outmanned almost 2-for-1 now, so Gong Sun San losing is only a matter of time. Cao Cao has 50,000 troops, but they're spread across four cities. If Liu Bei was being a little bit more aggressive, he could do some damage to Cao Cao, but Liu Bei has this random warlord, Sang Cheng, to the south. Yuan Shu is starting to consolidate the south along with his alliance Sun Jian, depending on if those two stay allies. Liu Biao is thriving. Jin Yi, Jian Yang, Jiang Xia, he's lost. Or maybe he never had Jianling to begin with. He hasn't taken Jianling. There's shenanigans over in Shu. That is our target. And the young man Wu Yi, there's hope we're going to be in fine addition to our army. So, we've got our goal, we have survived, which is the most important part of the start date, surviving. And in part two, we will hopefully be able to do much more than survive. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I will see you in the next one.